The focus of my talk is on our new software called MIPAR. I will just give a little bit of history. MIPAR, the development started in July last year during the Hackfest in Catania, Italy, and then we continued, even in Lagos, and we have made some presentations, and we completed the development in around December last year, and we got a huge support from Sci-GaIA. So I will just be saying, starting by saying a big thank you to Sci-GaIA team because of the support, huge support that we received even during the training in Catania and throughout the lifespan of MIPAR. And the collaboration still continues. Here's the overview of the talk today. So I will just give us a little bit of background as to what we did or what we are doing, and the scientific problem that we attempted solving, and the aims and benefits of the software that came out of this, and actually what is MIPAR. So I'll provide some information. What can you do, or what can you use MIPAR for? How MIPAR works and our future plans. So MIPAR is all about medical image analysis and repository. So when we talk about medical images, these are images acquired from human or animals, and they are normally used for diagnostics, for prognostics, for patient management, and then you can draw a lot of inference from medical images. And there are many methods of acquiring medical images. So for example, we can talk about X-ray. Everybody is familiar with X-ray, but that's not everything about it. X-ray lets you see the bones. But you can use MRI when you have hydrogen, in the tissue, like any tissue, that has a water molecule. And then we can have ultrasound and a host of others. Each of these has its own strength, and there are weaknesses. And there are, reasons for using each of the medical image, imaging technique. But the thing is, how do you process these images? Because when you acquire images, you get the raw images. But the target of any clinician or anybody interested in imaging is to be able to extract information from those. So the field of computer vision and image analysis creates a platform for you to develop computational techniques for extracting information from the raw images so that medics can use them. Now, the scientific problem is this. Imaging equipment are very expensive. At least you think about MRI scanner, it's not less than £1 million. If you're thinking about 1.5T Tesla, and that's about the minimum allowed in scientific research and clinical practice. So it's very expensive. So if the equipment are expensive, then for any patient to use them, you have to pay a lot of money as well. So they could be very expensive as well. And there are limited availability of image analysts, So we acquire images, and generally speaking, medics just look at the images. But by processing the images, you can get much, much more information from them, And we do not have a lot of, or many, medical image analyst in this part of the world. I can say for sure that in Nigeria, I'm the only medical image analyst. So how then, what do we do? Does it mean we shouldn't be processing our images? No. So it's a problem, and we just need to think of solving it. Now, there is limited collaboration efforts in this part of the world as well, And I want us, all of us, from Africa to learn from what our European guys are doing, It costs a lot of money, time, and efforts for somebody to acquire the kind of skills that the Sci-GaIA team has acquired. And they had to come to Africa, to train people, to invest money, invest time, But we just need to learn from that by increasing or improving on how we collaborate, how we work. We have common problems, and it takes us to solve the problem in Africa. So we need to really appreciate collaboration. But that is quite, we are not yet there in Africa. And so these are some of the problems, because I could have images and I'm the only one struggling with it, you know, but maybe the next door neighbor could actually help me, you know. So thinking about this, we started, thinking about developing an image analysis platform. But good enough, the advancement of internet technology, data communication, and the reduction in hardware cost has already created the platform for, you know, Science Gateway. And with Science Gateway, it's possible for us to create, you know, repositories. It's possible for you to put a dedicated software on a powerful machine, a server somewhere, and somebody can access that tool using SaaS, software as a service, just via the web. So with Science Gateway, this can be done. So in image analysis, it means then that rather than think of turning everybody to an image analyst, then we could just put the software somewhere, and then with little, with internet connection and with an internet browser, you can access the tools by submitting your images and then getting them processed, you know. So Science Gateway is in top gear in the developed world, but it's not, we're not doing pretty well in Africa. So we, but of course, we know that things will change, and that is why we're here, you know. So in particular, I said there that image analysis platform does not exist anywhere in Africa. Now, what is the aim of this research? So our aim was to develop an e-infrastructure that will serve as a repository and an image processor. So it can allow people to share images, and it can help people to actually process their images. You know, having a repository is not a big deal, you know, but putting a dedicated software which is accessible at a distance, you know, to processing images, it could be challenging if you don't have the right tools and the right skills. So why are we doing this? So there are benefits that we were expecting from this. One is improved and timely diagnostics. So when we are able to get access to, you know, the right platform for processing images, then clinicians could take decisions, you know, quicker enough, and that could save life, improve patient management. Life expectancy can improve when you have, you know, somebody who understands, you know, your situation, and we have, you know, who can interpret the data or the image and do diagnosis on time. So then prescription will be timely, and then life expectancy can actually improve. And I put here that it saves cost of traveling to other experts. You know, when you think about how disconnected we are sometimes, you know, and you need to actually get some expertise advice. You know, if you're a neurosurgeon, there could be some part of neuroscience that you are not quite comfortable with, and that is why we all work as a team, you know. So you need to talk to another expert. So, and that could require you to travel. But with this kind of a platform, you just submit your image, and then we can chat on the platform, and then problems could be solved even quicker. So what is MIPAR? MIPAR simply means Medical Image Processor and Repository. So it's an e-infrastructure for two purposes, sharing medical images and analyzing medical images. So those are the things. So for you to share, so meaning that you can submit, you can get images for free, and all on open science. So you don't pay anything, you know. And it's an outcome of a collaborative effort from us in computer vision division of Lagos State University and, you know, the Sci-GaIA. So we've been working together, and without the support from Sci-GaIA, I want to say confidently that MIPAR is impossible, you know. So if you want to know more about MIPAR, you can contact me. That's my email address. So when can I use MIPAR? Yes, good question. So we said we have a product. So the next thing is, why do I patronize you? Why do I need your product? Yes, you need my product if you need to. If you need medical images for your research, you know, so are you a research student or a researcher or a clinician? And you need medical images for you to understand or to solve a problem. So you need MIPAR, because free images will be available for you. You have medical images to share, so you're not just interested in taking the images, but you actually want somebody to have access to your images. And, you know, so MIPAR is there for you to donate your images. Of course, we're not going to pay you for that, so it has to be given freely. You have a case report to share. You know, in medical science, sometimes you have a case report, you got a particular image, and you've seen some things in the image that you think other experts should actually make comments. So through MIPAR, you can do that. You need an expert to process your medical images. Yes, so you don't need to travel far. You know, I want to tell you that, you know, I met a guy in University of Edinburgh about 5 years ago, and he's from Nigeria. So he got MRC funding, you know, to look at stroke patients in Nigeria. So he was able to, we have very small scanner in terms of field strength, that's 0.30 in Nigeria. And so he was able to get some scans done, but then there was no way he could process them. So he took them to the UK for processing in Newcastle. And he attended a conference in Edinburgh, and we met there. And he told me, when he made his presentation, and he said, the images are from Nigeria. I said, why didn't you process it in Nigeria? Nobody to do it. So I collected the images from him and brought them back to Nigeria to process. You can see. So what can we learn from that? So nobody to process the images acquired in Nigeria. So I collected the images in the UK, you know, brought them back to Nigeria to process. So that means there was no good link, you know. So if we've been working together, at least we will identify the expert somewhere, you know. So then we got the image processed. The good news is that we got a paper out of that. You know, how much do you pay for the service? Everything is free. You know, freely we receive, so freely we have to give. So talking about system analysis and design. So in software development, once you have conceived an idea, you want to develop a software. You want to understand, you know, how the existing system works manually, and then you design a new system. So we use what we call use case diagram in computer science. So this is an example of use case diagram. So what it simply says is, what can a user do with the platform? So you can donate images, you can process images, download images, download, free images and the outputs you can get. So when you, after processing your images, of course you want the output, you know. And what kind of images can you process? You know, this is just an example of what is possible at the moment. Our target is more than this, but currently we have in plan, you know, processing of CT scan, MRI, Doppler, ultrasound, you know, and different anatomy, you know, brain. Though we have tested with only brain images at the current time, but I've got some PhD students and MSc students working on liver and lung now, so that we can include those as time goes on. So in terms of format, yes, when you talk about repository, you need to think about the format. You cannot just go and upload anything, you know, because we have tested only with brain MRI. They come as 3D images. So you can only upload at the current time, you know, images that have the pair HDR, IMG, and the host of others. You know, but if you want to submit images to us and you search through and the format of your image is not available, please just drop me an email and we can make sure we include that. Processes, you know, in terms of brain imaging, you know, we have what we call brain extraction, image segmentation, and image registration. So all these are implemented already in MIPAR, but they will be extended as time goes on. System requirements. Yes, so the first set are, you know, the tools that we used during the development. You know, so all these, the first three, we learned in Catania, and then we were able to do the development. In terms of, from the user side, you know, all you need is web browser, internet, and then, you know, an operating system. And of course, you need to use federated identity, so you have to register. And you know, Roberto has told us a little bit about that. So, just a fairly decent, you know, machine is okay. Nothing particularly serious. So, once you have a standard computer, you are good to go. So, the modules of MIPAR. So, this is just giving a little bit of more information about the things that MIPAR can do. So the registration, you do not need to register on MIPAR if you have federated identity. So that's the registration. So you have registered and you can access MIPAR if you have federated identity. So you can donate images, yes, download images freely, and then process images and analyze images. So these are the four things that you can do on MIPAR. So this is the homepage of MIPAR, you know, so just giving some information. That's the URL in case you want to make notes and visit. And I want to encourage us, please just visit MIPAR. And if you have any suggestion on how we can improve it, you know, please drop me an email. So that's the homepage. So how do you access MIPAR? As I said previously, you need federated identity. So you just need to choose the one that relates to you. And, you know, if your institution or if there is none that relates to it, then cash out normally will be fine for you. That's the first option there. Then from cash out, if your institution is not there, then you actually go to IDP open and then you'll be able to access MIPAR. So some screenshots about how to use MIPAR. So this is the donation model. So in case you want to donate any images for us, all you need to do is to click on the donate images, and then you have the opportunity to choose the type of image and the anatomy, and then you click, you know, the upload, and you are able to upload and submit the images to us. And that's because we actually connect this with OAR. So OAR will receive the images and keep it. So you can search the images. Though you browse, you access through the interface, through the web, but at the back end, you have the OAR clone. So that is the OAR. And so this allows you to, once you do the upload, I need to say that DOI is generated automatically, you know, so that it's easy to search and to keep or track the images you have donated. So image search and download. So in case you want to download, then you are able to search through. So you just need to click the menu download images and you select the type of image and the anatomy, that's the body part. And that queries the database, you know, containing all the images we've got. And now it returns what all the hits. And so what you have here is an example of somebody searching the images. And the interest here, you know, is ultrasound brain images. And so you are able to then click and download to your local machine. So because I'm an expert in brain images, so I just gave example of a brain MRI. So what you have here, though we do not have a visual display, you know, software on MIPAR, but you need to get one on your local machine for you to be able to visualize your images. So this display is called MRI Crow, very small but very, very good, you know, image display tool. So with this, you can see all the different orientations of brain images, you know, the corona, the sagitta, and the axial view. So this image is available on MIPAR, and you can feel free to download it and play with it. So the model process, yes. So this is still growing, but for now, as I said, we have the brain images implemented there. So you can process brain images. You can do brain extraction. So to do that, you click the process, and all the processes that are available, you know, you can see them, and then you upload the image you want to process. Actually, you can process an image that is available on MIPAR or your own image. So you bring your image, you upload it, and then you choose the kind of processing you want to do. It's like you're actually seeking a service, so software as a service, and that is processed at the back end. So it doesn't actually depend on the how good your machine is, because the main machine is at the back end. I mean, it's available remotely. And so processes are done once you click the process button or proceed button. And now, you know, this is submission of the job, so still part of processing. And then you get your images processed. So we just experimented with this. So what we did here was just to submit a brain MRI image and then get it brain extracted. So brain extraction, they just mean that you remove what is not brain. When you scan the entire human brain, you get a 3D image and you have the skull, you know, the scalp, everything inside. But normally, we are not interested in the scalp or in the skull, so we remove that. So the process of removing what is non-brain is what we call brain extraction. So that's just an output. So the last module is the analyze module. So in this analyze module, we have simple statistics that you can do, you know, so we implement this using R. So what you can do, you can perform simple regression or multiple regression. You can do, you know, correlation analysis. You can compare two sets of data and two measurements. So these are simple, you know, analysis. So the future plan, yes, MIPAR is up and running. So, but we want to tell people more about MIPAR, and then we want to get more data into MIPAR. So our target is to get, you know, data largely from Africa. You know, one of the challenges of in, you know, science, as we will agree with me, is about data. So you have this idea, you want to do certain type of research and you need data. But repositories for images, or for images, you don't have them anywhere. You know, medical images from Africa, they are not available anywhere. So as time goes on, this will grow, and then we, you know, as and then people will be able to enjoy more about MIPAR. So we need to extend it by including, as I said, there are part of the teams are working on extending, including more anatomies and more imaging, you know, modalities. So in conclusion, you know, we want to say that the Katani Access, Lagos Access has been very, very extremely useful. So we had the opportunity through this Access, you know, to learn about Science Gateway, and we can see the output, you know, manifesting as a new baby, you know. So MIPAR gives you the opportunity to share, process, and analyze your medical images. Appreciation to all those who have supported us, you know, Sci-GaIA, Indigo, you know, in terms of the funding to attend the training in Catania, and the entire team. Echo Connect actually introduced us to Sci-GaIA, so we owe them a lot of appreciation for linking us, you know, up with great people, you know, and so that's the entire team, you know. So I want to appreciate everybody for listening. Thank you.